Our Adam Housley is streaming live outside the fish market in a city there. And Adam, what can you tell us about the nuclear concerns there?
Yeah, here at the Nakaminata Fish Market along the Japanese coast, about 70 miles away from that first reactor you talked about, the one that's caused the problems the last couple of days before the new reactor up the coast from there caused problems. People are talking about the threat that does exist around this entire region because of the fact you have three separate reactors right now that people are extremely worried about. Now, that evacuation area, we're told, is about 15 miles in circumference around both reactors. Up to 200,000 people for sure have already been evacuated. The government says maybe as many as 300,000 will be evacuated, and we do know that there are at least 19 scientists on at least one site where they're going through and checking each person that's being brought out to see what kind of radiation contamination they've been exposed to.
Yeah, Adam, we've been seeing some of the video of some of that radiation testing going on. So just where do you put more than 200,000 people who are evacuated in the middle of an earthquake zone?
Well, we're going to talk about that, too, and I want to show you something behind me. I'll answer that question. But before that, where we are right here, this fish market had about 10 feet come through it from the water lines around here. There were no fatalities, and this reminds me of what happened back in Thailand in 2004 and 2005, a very similar area we went to where thousands were killed. The reason why not one person was killed here and a significant part of the coastline in Japan was because of the tsunami warning system. So while the damage here is extensive, there were no deaths here. Now, the government is estimating potentially as many as 10,000 people have died all up the coast and partially inland. That's due to that massive wall of water that went a lot further than anybody expected in more rural areas, generally speaking. Now, as for the people who have been moved inland, they're being put in areas like a military base that's north and west of Tokyo. That's one area they're being taken to. A couple of other towns inland up next to the mountains that are about 60, 70 miles from the reactors. That's where some of those people are being evacuated to. But we're talking literally about several hundred thousand people that are being moved. And on top of that, Harris, there's more than 2 or 3 million that are dealing with without water, without gas, without power. I can tell you overnight in certain parts of this northern part of this island, it gets down to 26, 27 degrees. That means there's no gas to keep people warm, no electricity to do that as well. It's extremely cold here at night. That's one thing the government's very concerned about. They now have rolling blackouts that began to be instituted today, and that includes in Tokyo. It includes factories. People will be dealing without power for 3 or 4 hours purposely to help those who don't have power in the northern parts of the country.
Well, Adam, before I let you go, I have a quick question about what people may have with them. I mean, what were they able to grab, some of them, as they were leaving their homes?
Well, around here, the businesses were still open when the tsunami hit. So a lot of people live away from the coastline. Those who were on the coastline and left, they had maybe 10, 15 minutes, depending on where the location was. So basically, they grabbed what they had on their backs, maybe a couple of quick supplies, and they were out of the, out of the region. So you have a lot of people that really don't have a lot of stuff. In fact, we drove along this coastline earlier this morning, and you saw a lot of homes where people were just bringing all of their furniture, everything outside because the water came through, and they're literally piling it on the street and starting to clean out their homes that way. People lost a lot of things in this area. Now, as you move further north, where that massive wall of 20 to 30 feet came through, there's no house. There's nothing to come back home to if they even lived through that horrific event.
Yeah, I asked that in part because it is so cold. I wondered if people could even grab a coat. Adam Housley, thank you very much for this live report from the ground.
Yeah, that's a good question.
All right. Thank you, Adam.